I call upon Shri G.C. Chandrasekhar.
Thank you for the opportunity to speak about demand of grants for the Department of Tourism. Sir, our Indian culture preaches Atithi Devo Bhava, meaning equating a guest to God. We need to preserve it by building the trust of the tourist. Sir, and also travel makes the man wiser and make the country he visits richer. Hence, our focus on tourism is most important. Sir, the ministry had projected a demand of rupees 3,178.6 crores, but in the current financial year, 2021-22 budget, allocation is only rupees 2,026.77 crores, which is again 19% lesser than last budget, 2021, which was 2,499.83 crores, and also 1,111.29 crores lesser than compared to last demand made by the department. Sir, if we look at the difference between budget estimate actual expenditure year-wise, sir, 2018 and 19, 47.47 crores has not spent. And 2019-20, 789.1 crore has not spent. And 2020-21, 1,239.83 crores. Sir, one side we are talking about the budget allocation, and another side, the money what we have been allocated, that has been not spent. Sir, totally, for these 3 years, so 1 year budget, last year whatever the budget has, this year whatever the budget has given, allocated, the same amount in last 3 years, they are not spent. This is the situation. Sir, government has announced some new scheme. Some of them are under the review of the Prime Minister's Office itself, the important programs. The example, sir, Swadesh Darshan scheme sanctioned 76 projects in 2014 and 15, but till now only 9 projects have been completed. Another 67 projects are still pending. Sir, although rupees 5,667.40 crores has been sanctioned for all these schemes, but as and today, actual expenditure is only rupees 3,458.60 crores. Sir, this is the status of project even when the Prime Minister's Office itself is reviewing the projects. Sir, can you just imagine the other project which the Prime Minister's Office is not overlooking? Sir, one more important thing is, as per the Standing Committee Tourism report to March 2021, underutilized fund rupees 1,239.83 crores has been surrendered to the Ministry of Finance without spending. That is a huge amount, 1,239. That is the Standing Committee report, what I am quoting here. Sir, to promote the domestic tourism, the government has introduced Prashad scheme in 2015, but only 11 out of 26 projects has been completed till today. As per the report of Standing Committee, the estimated expenditure of sum of rupees has been, you know, spent, allocated 1,160.55 crores, although actual releases as on today, sir, only 629.50 crores. Sir, tourism is the second largest foreign exchange earner in India. The tourism industry employs a large number of people, both skilled and unskilled, more than 75 million people. Sir, tourism is largest service industry in India with contribute of 10% of national GDP. Sir, Indian tourism industry accounted for rupees 16.91 lakh crore and 9% of the total employment in India. But this industry hit badly by corona, and there is estimated revenue loss of rupees 95,000 crores in both organized and unorganized sectors in this industry, sir. Sir, corona affected 75 million people with zero foreign exchange earning in the last year. And less than 25% of pre-pandemic revenue, the sector is facing the crisis. Sir, Indian Association of Tour Operators has estimated that the hotel, aviation and travel sectors collectively loss of rupees 85 billion due to the restriction imposed on the travel and tourism. So the Indian domestic travels and FTAs witnessed a significant decline in 2020. India's foreign tourist arrival stood at 10.9 million and the foreign exchange earnings stood at rupees 2,10,971 crores during the 2019. See, another study projected that the Indian tourism industry is going to book a revenue loss of rupees 1.25 trillion, which is 40% loss compared to 2019. See, as per the information shared by the tourism secretary in Parliamentary Standing Committee on Transport and Tourism and Culture, sir, 2 to 5.5 crore employed in the sectors directly or indirectly have lost their jobs. This is a very, very huge number, sir, what I am telling you here. The secretary also informed that the panel and the revenue loss of rupees 1.58 lakh crore. That also huge amount. Sir, tour operators and agencies are expected to incur the loss of 35,000 crores, with the hotels likely to see 80 to 85% loss. Sir, but when there was a question asked in the Lok Sabha regarding the revenue loss in the tourism sector, the Ministry of Tourism says it does not maintain the data on revenue generated and the department yet to conduct the NCERCR survey. Sir, if the ministry does not maintain the data of the people whose livelihood is affected, how can we trust this government, sir? And how can government take care of the people properly, you tell me, sir? Sir, I would like to mention some suggestions. Since the tourism department does not have its own assets and the hospitality entities owned are not maintained well, as you know that very well, all over the country, so that tourists prefer private entities. So government need to adapt the new tourism policy strategy with PPP model. Sir, I propose the body which monitors to the product the services for the international and domestic tourists, sir, where the grievances can be addressed. So regulatory body should be given a power to cancel the recognition and also encourage the service provider and keep up the brand value of India. Sir, Udaan scheme. So India has a potential for the airport connectivity with airports across the states. Charter tourism should be encouraged by the simplifying process, sir. Currently, we need to take permission from many departments like aviation department, GDA, DGCA, fire, PWD, local and DC, in foreign affairs, etc., including states, to land the chartered flights. Sir, I would like to quote an example here. During the corona pandemic, although there was Vande Bharat mission flights were arranged for the reporting across the globe, the medical students, those who are studying in Russia from our state, Karnataka, were finding difficult for a flight. Finally, when we made arrangement to the chartered flights, in despite of corona pandemic, sir, but it was very hard to get the permission from many departments to land the chartered flights. Sir, and also, our state student could not speak in Hindi. The Indian embassy in Russia has denied the permission to board the students under the Vande Bharat mission flights. Sir, those flights were flying from Oya, Moscow, Delhi to Bangalore. The embassy had asked apology regarding this issue, regarding this discrimination. What they have done it, there are the reports, sir. I think it has come in the national newspapers also. So when the Indian embassy could not take care of our students, our country students during this time of crisis, how do we expect some of our embassies to handle our foreign tourists? Sir, I propose to have a single window process of permission to chartered flight to ease the process. See, as the tourist destinations are not direct control of our tourism department, we need to create a SEG for tourism in and around the tourist destination, sir. Sir, at present we are having entire country 47 institution of hotel managements and 14 food craft industries and one central IHM under implementation, there is a huge gap of skill in this sector. Sir, training programs such as Hunar Se Rojgar Tak programs and entrepreneurship programs failed to meet the target of financial year 2020. And again, there is no data on the skilled manpower to supply the hospitality sector, to this hospitality sector, sir. So I would like to propose classify hospitality under the RBI infrastructure leading norms criteria, industry status to hotels, restaurants, and resorts across the country to include in the concurrent list. Some MAT waiver at least for 1 year is required. IGST billing to hotels and corporate and MICC's booking also is most important. Sir, single window clearance for all the approvals would ease the process of establishing travel and hospitality venture and more investment in this space. Sir, there are different rates of GST for the hotel accommodation starting from 0 to 18%, depending upon the room's tariff, sir. Sir, GST on room tariff above 7,500 is 18%. See, Government of India should consider reduction in GST rate on rooms tariff between 1,000 to 7,500 from the current 12% and 18% to 5% at least for 1 or 2 years. So tour operators and travel agents are required to pay GST on their commission for supplying their services that can be considered reduced. Otherwise, you know, those people also living is very difficult to do the business now. So tax holiday may be introduced for a specified period to safeguard the interest and the revival of such services, service providers. So also, online tax aggregators are required to collect the tax collection at the sources. So while remitting the payment to airlines and hotels, exemption on such levy as TCS must be considered to avoid the additional burden of taxes. Sir, government is claiming there is a revival of MSME sectors providing packages through banks. Sir, we know that how banks are giving the loans, how difficulty to avail the loan in the banks in the time, and how many MSMEs are closed today because of the policies and also the banks. Sir, at least unorganized sector workers who they are working, earning about 300 to 500 rupees per day, they're selling some items at tourist places need to be taken care, sir, immediately. Sir, governments across the world are trying to revive back visitors from the domestic and international market. I would like to quote few. Sir, Hong Kong and Singapore have come up with a digital initiative, Travel Bubble. Sir, Travel Bubble will allow people to move quarantine-free in each direction. A total of 200 residents from each city will be able to travel on one-day basis. Sir, European countries has launched a website which travel rules for Europe. The website provides information on the coronavirus rules of individual European countries and in 24 languages. Even in India, we have 22 languages as official language. We are not getting in 24 language information. We are getting only in 2 languages, that is English and Hindi. Sir, this is in Japan. Has launched an ambition go to campaign aims to provide subsidies of up to 50% of domestic travels. 50%, sir. Greece also effectively mitigated the impact of the pandemic. The country reduced the VAT on all modes of the transport, sir. Sir, with this, I would like to conclude my speech, and the government will revive and help the save the industry. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Chandrasekhar ji. I now request Sri S.R. Balasubramaniam.
Honorable Chairman, thanks for giving me an opportunity to speak on the